So I've been teaching piano recently online, and I've been using a mic and a stereo keyboard going through a Scarlett 4i4 interface. That's been fine, but sometimes the audio levels are not quite right, and I've also found that the audio and the video in Zoom do not necessarily appear in sync. So I've recently been using Audio Hijack and Loopback software, all produced by Rogue Amoeba, to tweak the audio and get it in a state that it's better for Zoom. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. I'm just going to draw out what I mean. So I've got a mic coming in, and I've also got a stereo keyboard. So this is going through the Scarlett. And the mic is coming in on channel one, and the keys are actually coming through on channels three and four. So what I'm actually doing is putting that through to Audio Hijack, and what I'm going to be doing is processing that audio. I'm going to be changing the levels. I'm also adding some delay to the audio to synchronize it. From there, it goes into Loopback. I give it a title, so I think I call it Mic and Keyboard. And that goes into Zoom. So in Zoom, I just select the microphone that says mic and keyboard. So all the audio processing is happening in Audio Hijack. Right, so let's jump into Audio Hijack and I can explain a bit more about how it works. So you can see that there are input devices on the left-hand side, and the one on the top is the mic. It then goes into a bit of processing that makes sure it's mono. And then there's a little module here called volume. So this is where I'm introducing a bit of boost. And then I'm applying a delay on the audio in this module called sync. And then it goes out to an output device called mic and keyboard. Okay, so this is where the processing is happening. Now this, if I just show you on the bottom there, the other input device is the keyboard. So this won't show when I click on it, but actually that's assigned to the Scarlett channel 3 and 4 that I explained earlier on. So this is then going through a similar volume adjustment, and that's going up to the delay there as well and out to the output device. So if I play the keyboard now, you'll hear the sound come through. It shows it in the graphical display there. So this is where it all takes place. And there are various other, if you look on the right-hand side, there are various kind of options that you can change on the audio. There's EQ, balance, filters, ducking, all sorts of things. And in theory, if you have a plugin, like an AU plugin or a VST plugin, it should appear there as well. Okay, so that's the processing. It's all coming out on this output device called mic and keyboard. So if I jump through to Loopback now, what I've done here is created a pass-through device in Loopback. That's how it all works. So you can actually select the sources. For those that have used Loopback before, you basically just select any source on your computer. That could be a browser or a microphone, and you can add the sources there and create an aggregate mix. But in this case, all I want to do is pass through the work that Audio Hijack has done. And yes, just a pass through. So that's the way I set that up, is just set sources and then select pass through. Okay, so that is called mic and keyboard as a virtual device. So all I need to do is go to Zoom and on the virtual microphone set mic and keyboard. So it works. It's a pretty good way of introducing a delay and some modifications to the audio. I am interested to see about latency, and there is certainly some latency because I'm using more software to process the audio. So in the future, I don't know, I may try a hardware mixer as well to see if this works. But certainly for now, it's a way of using software together to improve the audio for a Zoom session. Okay, hope that's been useful. And if you have any questions about Loopback or Audio Hijack used together, please put them in the comments and I'll try to answer them.